Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise Jesus, praise Jesus, praise God. Wherever you are in the nation of Kenya, wherever you are in the entire world, my name is Pastor John Ngaho of Blessings Revival Center, Church Kigumo, in the county of Kiambu, in our country, Kenya. And today I have come so that we can pray together. Today is the day that I've come so that we can do one noble thing, to pray for our nation, Kenya. But before we pray for our nation, I want us to listen to a small word of God and to a small peace, so that we can listen to the voice of God and we can listen to what God is saying. First of all, I want us to pray so that we can start this service of today. And I know that God shall bless you, and I know that God shall listen unto us. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you. We thank you because of this time, oh God, that we are preparing ourselves to pray you. Father, Lord, I know that you have good things for us. You have good plans for our nation, Kenya, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father. May you be with me as I take this nation to our mode of prayer. May you be with me, oh Father. May you speak through me to your people, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father, because I know even now you're going to be with me as I speak. And whatever I'm going to speak, it's not me who speak, but it is you through me. May your name be glorified through me. May your name be glorified through your word, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father, because you have heard us. Thank you, Father, because you're going to continue answering our prayers. In the name of Jesus, we do pray, trusting and believing. Amen. 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 Wherever you are, I remind you, my name is Pastor John Ngaho of Blessings Revival Center Church, Kigumo, in the county of Kiambu. And today we are going to listen to word of God. And our noble thing today, our noble act today, is to pray for our nation, Kenya. My message to you today is that Kenya belongs to God, is that Kenya belongs to Jesus, is that Kenya belongs to Jehovah. I want us to listen to the word of God, and we listen and hear what God has for us today. And I want us to open our Bibles, be it that you're using the normal Bible, be it that you have your Bible in your smartphone, wherever, whatever you're using to get the scriptures of God from the Holy Bible. May you go to 2 Chronicles chapter 7 and verse 14. 2 Chronicles chapter 7 and verse 14. The Bible says, and this is God who is speaking, God is saying, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear them from heaven, and I will forgive their sin, and I will heal their land. The Bible says, if my people who have called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways. If my people, if as Kenyans we are going to listen to God, if as Kenyans we are going to pray God, if as Kenyans we are going to stop doing anything else and seek the face of God, if as Kenyans we are going to turn from our wicked ways, God is saying that then I will hear them from heaven, and I will forgive their sin, and will heal their land. If we stop doing all the wicked things that we've been doing, if you stop what bad things that you've been doing, my fellow Kenyan, God is saying that if you stop doing that, and if you start praying, and if you start seeking his face, God is saying that he will forgive us your sin. He will forgive your sin. He will forgive your sin. He will forgive our sin, and he will heal our land, in the name of Jesus. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear them from heaven, and I will forgive their sin and heal their land. God is telling us, our fellow Kenyans, God is telling us to stop our sins. God is telling us to start praying him. God is telling us to start seeking for him. God is telling us to stop doing our wicked things and start searching for his face. And Jehovah is saying now that if we stop doing those wicked things, if we start seeking his face, if we start praying him, he is going to listen us. And after listening us, he's going going to answer our prayers. And lastly, in 2 Chronicles chapter 7 and verse 14, God is finalizing that verse by saying that, "And I will heal the land." God is saying that if we stop our wicked ways, if we start praying God, if we start seeking for His face, He is going to heal our nation, Kenya. I want us to get into the mood of prayer, because once we start praying, once we start seeking God, once we stop sinning, God is going to heal our nation, Kenya. God is going to heal you, my brother. God is going to heal you, my sister. We go straight to 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 1 and 2. 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 1 and 2. I want you to open your Bible in 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 1 and 2. The Bible says, "I urge then, first of all, that petitions, prayers, intercession, and thanksgiving be made for all people, for kings and all those in authority, and that we may live peaceful and quiet lives in all godliness and holiness." The Bible is saying that God is urging that before doing anything else, we do petitions. We do petitions. We bring together those people who are not listening to one another. We do prayers. We intercede. We give thanksgiving. And this has to be made for all people. It is not just for those who are sick. It is not just for those who are sleeping hungry. The intercession should be done to everybody. The prayer that we are going to do as men of God, we are not going to pray for some special people. The petition that we are going to do as men of God, we are not going to do to anybody else. We are going to do to everybody. And the Bible is saying in 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 1 and 2, that we should pray for the kings and those in authority. Before we pray for everybody else, we should pray for our kings. We should pray for our president. We should pray for our deputy president. Before we pray for anybody else, we should pray for our ministers. Before we pray for anybody else, we should pray for everybody who is in authority, that we may live peaceful and quiet lives in all godliness and holiness. God is telling us one thing, my fellow Kenyans. It is time to leave everything else. It is time to start praying God. It is time to start doing intercessory. It is time to do petitions. It is time to pray for those in authority. It is time, in short, to pray for our nation in the mighty name of Jesus. My brother and my sister, my fellow Kenyan, wherever you are, it is not time to dine and drink. It is not time to do other funny things. This is a high time that we should sit down. This is our high time to sit down and to pray God. This is our high time to go to sacred places and start praying Jehovah. And God is saying that once we start praying Him, God is going to forgive us our sin, and God is going to heal our land Kenya. God is going to protect our land Kenya from every sickness, from every sickness. God is going to heal our nation from every trouble. God is going to heal our nation. If we stop doing anything else, if we stop doing the bad things that we've been doing and start praying God and start doing petition and start doing intercessory, God is going to listen unto us. I tell you, my brother and my sister, it is not a must we wait until our government organizes our prayer day in Moi ground. It is not a must we wait for our government to organize for prayers in Uhuru Park. It is not a must we wait for our government to organize for prayers in Safari Park. It is not a must we wait for our government to organize for prayers in Safari Park. In the name of Jesus, it is not a must, in short, we wait for our government to organize and call all men of God together so that we can pray for our nation. We can also pray our nation now. I am requesting you to share this sermon. I am requesting you kindly share this prayer. And I know as we pray, God is going to heal our nation in the name of Jesus. The Bible is saying in 1 Kings, I want us to read 1 Kings chapter 8 and verse 28. 1 Kings chapter 8 and verse 28. "Yet give attention to your servant's prayer in his plea for mercy, Lord my God, hear the cry and the prayer that your servant is praying in your presence this day. This is a servant of God who is praying, God, and is requesting God to listen the prayer of his servant. And this is the prayer that I'm also doing to my God today. Jehovah, may you listen to my prayer. Jehovah, may you listen to the prayer of Kenyans. Jehovah, may you listen to the prayer of your servant in Kenya. Jehovah, may you answer for the prayers that your people are going to pray you today. Jehovah, may you listen to your people as each and every Kenyan goes to prayer. Jehovah, may you listen us in the name of Jesus. Jehovah, you've told us once we pray you, you're going to heal our land in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, because I know that today, this is the day you are going to heal us in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, as we start praying you, may you listen to us, Jehovah. Thank you, Jehovah, because I know that this is the moment that you are going to heal our nation. Lord, I know that our nation is going through hard things. Lord, our nation, I know that our nation is sick in the name of Jesus. At this moment, we have too much, oh God, that Corona has brought into our nation. But Jehovah, I believe as your servant that you're going to heal our nation. You have told us, Jesus, that if we pray you, you are going to heal our nation. Lord Jesus, as your servant, I am praying you now that, Father, may you surround our nation with your angels. I am praying from Turkana all the way to Kilifi, from Kwale all the way to Mandera. May you, Father, touch each and every county of this nation of Kenya, oh God. Father, Lord, I know we have hospitals in each and every corner of our nation. May you, Father, heal everybody who is sick in our nation. Father, Lord, I know that with you, Corona is something very small. With you, Jehovah, you are going to make us get healed of Corona. I know the Lord Jesus, our nation is sick. I know the Lord Jesus, we have gone against you. But I pray for forgiveness of our nation. I pray that you forgive our sins, Jehovah. May you forgive each and every Kenyan, oh Jesus. Thank you, Father, because I know through this prayer of your servant, oh Jesus, you are going to change our nation, Kenya. May you, Father, bless the people of Turkana. May you, Father, bless the people of Marsabit. May you, Father, bless the people of Wajir. May you, Father, bless the people of Mandera. May you, Father, bless the people of Garissa. The people of Tana River, bless them, oh Jesus. May you, Father, bless the people of Lamu. May you, Father, bless Kilifi people, Mombasa people. May you, Father, bless them. Kwale people, Tana River, Taita, Tadeleta, Kitui, Makueni, Machakos, oh Jehovah. May you, Father, bless the people. Thank you, Father, because I know you are going to bless the people of Embu County. You are going to bless the people of Tharaka Nithi. You are going to bless the people of Meru, people of Laikipia, people of Nyeri, people of Muranga, people of Kiambu, oh Jesus. Thank you, Jehovah, because you are going to bless them. Oh Jehovah, you are worthy. Oh Jehovah, you are wonderful. Jehovah, you are miraculous, oh God. May you, Father, heal the people of Nakuru. May you, Father, heal the people of Baringo. May you, Father, heal the people of Gelgemarkwet, oh Jehovah. People of Trans Nzoia, people of Kakamega, people of Siaya, and the entire western region, oh God. All the counties in the western region, oh God. May you, Father, heal all those people in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, I know that you have the power to make our nation go back to its normal activities, oh Jesus. Thank you, Father, because I know from today onwards, oh God, our nation is going to stand tall. You are the same God who was there with the Israelites, oh Jesus. Even if other people were being killed by your angels, people of Israelites were spared by you. I request and I pray, the Lord Jesus, may you spare our nation Kenya. Even if other nations are suffering from Corona, may you, Father, spare our nation Kenya. May you, Father, heal our nation Kenya in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, because I believe that this is going to be a moment of change. This is going to be a moment of change in the name of Jesus. May you, Father, remember our president, oh God. Jehovah, remember our president, oh Jesus. Wherever he is, may you remember him, Jesus. I pray for our president, Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. May you, Father, bless him wherever he is. I pray the Lord Jesus, you remember his deputy, William Ruto, oh God. May you, Father, bless him and do him cool things, oh God. I pray, Father, you remember the right honorable Raila Odinga. May you, Father, bless him and uplift him, oh God. I pray, Father, you remember all ministers, oh Jesus. May you, Father, bless them, do them good, oh God. I remember all senators. I remember all members of parliament. I remember all governors, oh Jesus. I remember all women representative. I remember all county representative, county ward representative, oh Jesus. May you remember them, oh God. I remember all ambassadors of this nation. May you remember them and protect them, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Those who are sick, may you give them healing. Those who are sick, may you give them healing in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jehovah. Because I know that you have healed our nation, Kenya. Our economy, you have healed it, oh Jesus. Our economy is going to go back to normal. Our children are going to go back to school. Your holy places are going to be opened, oh God. All marketplaces that have been closed, you are going to make them open in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, because I know the Lord Jesus. There is someone who is going hungry because of Corona. May you, Father, be the provider. Thank you, Father, because I know there is somebody who have lost his or her job, oh God. May you, Father, become the provider in the name of Jesus. There is someone whose business has gone down, oh God. May you, Father, revive that business in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jehovah. Remember your servant in the nation of Kenya. May you, Father, help them to be your servant and your true servant, oh God. As they pray you, oh Jehovah, may you listen to our prayers. May you listen to their prayers in the name of Jesus. I declare that our nation is healed. I declare that Kenya is healed from north to west, oh God. Our nation is healed from east to south, oh Jehovah. Our nation is healed in the name of Jesus. I blow a trumpet of healing in our nation. I blow a trumpet of healing in our nation in the name of Jesus. Father Lord, I ask for rain in our nation. May we, Father, have enough rain to make us plant our plants and grow, oh Jesus. To make us plant our plants and grow until harvesting time, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Make our land to become more fertile in the name of Jesus. Make our businesses to prosper in the name of Jesus. May you, Father, return our country to normal in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, because you've heard my prayer. Thank you, Father, because you've heard our prayer. May you continue receiving our prayer, oh God. May you continue answering our prayer, Jehovah, in the name of Jesus. We thank you and we glorify you. Continue covering our nation with the blood of Jesus Christ. Continue covering our nation with your healing. Continue doing miracles in each and every county in the name of Jesus. I speak to everybody who is in ICU. I speak life to that person, oh God. I speak life to that person, oh God. May that person receive healing. May that person receive life in the name of Jesus. Everybody who is in ICU in our nation, Kenya, I speak life to that person. That is not going to be the portion of this person. Everybody who is in hospital bed, I speak life to this person in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jehovah. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jehovah. Thank you, Jesus. Continue healing our nation. Continue listening to your people in the name of Jesus. We do pray, trusting and believing. Wherever you are, say amen, amen, amen. God bless you. God, do you wonders? I pray that our nation may continue being healed, and I pray that wherever you are, may you continue praying, God. May you continue listening from God. May you continue doing what God wants you to do. May you continue stopping doing the wicked things, and may you continue living in a glory and in a way that God wants you to live, in a way that God wants our people in our Kenyan territory to live, in the name of Jesus. Even our bordering countries, people who are in Ethiopia, people from Uganda, people from Somalia, people from other nations, people from Saudi Arabia, people from Rwanda. I know that all these nations that are surrounding our nation, Kenya, these nations are going to be healed in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jehovah. Continue praying wherever you are, my fellow Kenyans. And I know that God is going to heal our nation. And I know that God is going to continue listening to us. Corona is not here to finish us. Corona is not here to finish you. Corona is here to make you more stronger. And I guarantee you and I tell you that after this moment, our nation is going to rise again and our nation is going to be very powerful. People are going to come from all corners of this world to come to this nation of Kenya. People are going to admire our nation. In the name of Jesus, God bless you. God bless you. May you continue praying, God. May you continue living right. And God shall continue listening to you. And God shall continue blessing you. Be blessed. God bless you. My name is Pastor John Gahu of Blessings Revival Center Church, Kigumo, in the county of Kiambu. If you want to reach me, you can call me through the number 0715-619-700. 0715-619-700. The same thing, if you want to see me, you can come to Thika Town, call that number, and I'm going to meet you wherever you are. I'm going to tell you where we are going to meet. If you want to come to church, may you come to Blessings Revival Center, Kigumo, Kiambu. And when you come there, you're going to find me on Sundays. I know the churches are going to be opened, and I know that we shall go back to our churches, and I know the name of God shall continue to be glorified in the name of Jesus. God bless you. God do you great. Shalom, shalom, shalom.